kind of aroma, yeah. Because that lighter bell blends in subtle. Whereas Chester is gray all over with only a subtle lighter gray stripe along the belly, and that's coloring similar to pilot wings. So take note of the colors that you see. Also, when you see a dolphin out in the ocean, take note of the size of the animal. If you see a dolphin that's about 2 meters in length or about 6 feet, that could be a Pacific white-sided dolphin. Now, false killer whales can grow to be much larger. At full size, they can get up to 6 meters or about 20 feet. That's about the width of that green tent to my right. Right now, Chester's only 2 years old, so he has many more years to grow. Other than the color and the size of the animal, also take a look at the dorsal fin. Now, as Chester swims around the habitat, you can see the part that is sticking up out of the water, slicing through the water there. That's the dorsal fin. And that dorsal fin right along the back there is made of soft material called cartilage, same stuff that makes our ears and our nose. And if you have your cameras up today, I challenge you to take a good photograph of that dorsal fin along the back. Because if you can take a good photo of a dorsal fin on any whale, porpoise, or dolphin, and send it to our BC Cetacean Sightings Network, the color pattern and the unique shape can be used to identify the animal, just like fingerprints. So remember to take a look at that dorsal fin, and take a look at the size of the animal and the color of the animal to help you identify what you're seeing out in the ocean. And then you can tell us where you're seeing them to our BC Cetacean Sightings Network. All right, are you ready to report all of your sightings now? If you want to participate in this very important research, you can start by downloading our free Whale Report app. Whale Report is all one word, and you can download that app that gives you photographs of the local species that you might see to help you identify them, and then you can tell us where you saw them. You can also go to the website at wildwhales.org. With your support, dolphins have a greater chance of survival because of the research programs happening here at the BC Cetacean Sightings Network. The Vancouver Aquarium is a non-profit organization dedicated to the conservation of marine wildlife, and we couldn't do it without your support. So on behalf of myself, on behalf of the dolphins and the trainers, thank you so much for being here today for the 1 o'clock training session, and have a wonderful rest.